Morning, we have been saying, and we know there are so many accessibility for us to buy anything, where whatever we need for ourselves, you know. But how about our own health? That I believe we dream of a world where being healthy is not a privilege or choice, but a way of life. And we are focused on chronic disease. Chronic disease means lifestyle disease, cancer, cardiac pain, hypertension, diabetic, liver problems. These disease patients, you know, we want to improve their quality of life, you know, by integrating patients with their own doctors and with the pharmaceutical manufacturers. Why we are doing it? Because there are many gaps today in the healthcare system which need to bridge. The biggest gap is accessibility. We have accessibility to so many things, but not to the healthcare. We cannot buy consultancy, we cannot buy so many knowledge. We have to go physically to a doctor, we have to go physically to visit a website and find something. The lack of knowledge for chronic disease, because they need to have a certain lifestyle, certain diet, certain knowledge about contraindication, how to take care, how to control from escalating the way disease. Number of doctors in India also very less. If the WHO recommends one doctor for 1,000 patients, we have got one doctor for 1,400 to 1,500 patients. Reach in the rural market is a gap. And the emotional support what they need a patient. To bridge the gap, we have created an ecosystem where there is a mobile app for a patient, so the Android and iOS phone they can download free. They get the educational message, head tips, videos to take care of their life. They can share their results with the doctors, the consultancy. Patients in India cannot understand English. So we have got a multilingual app, so we can reach to the patients in their language, you know, and give the message what they need. Pan-India patients don't have the access to the specialty products. You know, when they come to Mumbai or metro cities, they get treatment. When they go back, certain devices, certain medicines are not available. We need to give access to them, those tier 2, tier 3 cities. Doctor has web portal, mobile app to monitor patients, give them, bridge the gap between the treatment and consultants. And it's a paid consultancy, the doctor is not worried. Today his pain point is patients coming on the WhatsApp, calling on the phone, no payment of fees, and taking advice. That's we are solving his pain points. Pharma industry need to reach to the person, and they have resources to do all this. Doctor doesn't have resources. Only pharmaceutical manufacturer can do it. And they want to do this because they need to reach to the patient's community. Just give you an idea, a marketplace about for a patient to do everything. Our USP multilingual call center is there because patients in India cannot have a smartphone, so we need can reach to them to the mobile app and to the call center and give them message in IRS or voice call. Chronic disease, patient education and easy access to the app. This is all our USP. We empower access to healthcare anytime, anywhere. Why we are integrating pharmaceutical software? Because pharma has, patients want the desired solutions and pharma can give the knowledge, emotional support, medication adherence. Today globally billions of dollars lost to the pharma happens because of non-compliance of doses by a patient, which is lost to the pharma in the revenue and the loss to the patient because they are not able to be cured. Pharma wants to improve this medication adherence, they want to. The market is big. 1 million doctors in India. You can see that there are 1.2 billion mobile users, 250 million smartphone users in India. Out of 1.2 million population of India, 300 million is a middle class. And there is, ironically or incidentally, 300 plus million chronic disease patients who are suffering diabetes or hypertension. Many patients are having two diseases. All these patients, they have a paying capacity, they have a smartphones. We need to reach to them. This is a revenue model which comes from the doctors, pharma company, NGO. I have a team of young and experienced I think my co-founder is not present today, but Simran and Manav, they all are young, very passionate, doing marketing and other things. We have the doctors on our board. Pharmaceutical companies globally are reaching to the patients. It is legal and pharmaceutical companies are. Why they want to reach the patient? Because chronic patient have it, has to take medicine like that. And they need to comply the medications as well as the doctor's prescription or lifestyle. Doctor has no time. Patient who is not educated, they cannot do it.
There are applications which help me manage my daily medication doses.
Sir, that reminder coming is not only enough. You need to have knowledge about the disease. There are so many diseases. Diabetes, 300 type of diabetes. Doctor even cannot understand or anyone. Every person needs a different type. We need to educate them. Complications, retinopathy, what are the symptoms, when they should go to doctor. We say not reaching to doctor in time when the complication happens. So many indications which crop up during your disease, we do not report. So we want to educate them and which is the pharma company wants to do it and they do it. Today if you see even in India, website of Sanofi, website of Glenmark, website of Order, Ocard, even the Vivo, that oil. See, they have got lot of articles, lot of blogs about diabetes, which type of food, what type of exercise. Now, how many patients are able to reach to the website and reading them? We want to reach them through mobile, which is available to them. They can read it when they want, so they can create and have it. Even the pharma also wants to reach to them through the mobile. Why they are on mobile? They do not know my patients. No, because pharma goes to a doctor and then they don't know patient. Now we can connect them through a doctor to the patient. If they can reach to the patient, they want to reach to them directly. Education, increasing compliance, increasing revenue increase. Compliance happens with the building the habit. Habit happens when there's a persistence, follow, motivation, reward.
Wouldn't the regulatory authority work?
Sir, it is EU, the most regulated country is the US. There you see Pfizer.
I'm talking about India.
No, no, sir. See, we follow. India follows the rules and regulations, what is happening in that world. They are allowing patients, pharmaceutical companies to reach to the patients. We are going digital today. Telehealth is legal there. We are going now. Connecting the patient, education, most important. It is allowed, officially done, rewarding the patients is done. It is easy for them to do it because their total distribution system is to the pharmacy and they are able to do through pharmacy.
But telemedicine is a challenge in India.
That's why we are going through this. We are enabling our patients to stay connected with the doctor. Share the report, doctor can monitor. There are chronic patients, diabetic, whose sugar level goes up and down daily basis. And there are doctors who will ask, aap phone karo mere clinic mein roz receptionist ko batao kya sugar level ka kal ka, I'll give you the dose of insulin, you do it. Now, this is cumbersome, difficult, you test your results on your mobile, you update it, goes to the doctor, doctor can monitor, doctor will advise you.
The reason why I'm asking is because I'm currently mentoring three healthcare startups.
Legally,
trust me, scalability is a big issue.
Yes, scalability is a big issue. That is the reason we are connecting pharmaceuticals. When a pharmaceutical company comes on the platform, he has got 10,000 doctors, 20,000 doctors, because 4,000, 2,000, 500 medical labs meeting these doctors. They have a network. They can promote the platform to them. And through them, they can connect to their patients. Other medical apps which are in the market, including Labrador, Rectop, they go one-to-one doctor. So doctor acquisition cost is more, time required is more. So we are doing that also. But when we being a pharmaceutical company, scalability is
how many pharma companies do you have currently?
We already done one POC with the pharma company, therapy, another POC we are going to start soon. But that is our USP for the scalability. And this, we are enabled to send message to a patient with the disease, related with the pharma product, connected with the doctor. So you send a message to a patient, if you diabetic, only diabetic concern message goes to him, not cancer related or kidney related. Or other medical apps, they send message, it goes to all the patients. Here you give, otherwise patients will get bored, they will get irritated.
Exactly, that's another big
yes. So you identify a patient with a diabetic,
In-app messages,
it can go, it can have videos, it can have blogs. You click, the blog is there on the website, they can read the blogs, the videos. For non-phone smartphone users, IRS, voice call, and SMS. Because we need to connect to the pan India, it's not that only smartphone users are diabetic. The poor guys are also diabetic. A young person is diabetic, 70 years old is diabetic. You need to reach to them. And that's why the multilingual.
Great. Thank you.